Whether you have euros or pounds, Vietnamese dong or Russian ruble. Girl, my mama got some Vietnamese dong. It is time to have your money at the ready. That's because Eurovision tickets are going on sale. Are you ready? Let's do this! Yes, the first batch of tickets will be released on November 30th. That, of course, is much, much earlier than last Eurovision cycle when they didn't go on sale until February.
Mark the time, too, because it goes on sale at 11 a.m. CET, Central European time, that is. Because if you check in at 11 p.m.,
you're not gonna miss it! So November 30th, 11 a.m. CET.
Yes.
I am so excited. Now, Devin, how much are they gonna cost?
The base level tickets are gonna start from 35 euros.
But 35 euros.
But they do go up to 300 euros.
300 euros. What does that include?
Well, you get a euro back. It's 299!
You get a what?
You get a euro back. It's 299.
Oh, 299. Okay, 299 euros. Nice round number there.
I guess that will give you the best vantage points to see your favorite acts real, real close.
But you know what? This is interesting. I always find that regardless of where I'm seated, whether it's, you know, the very front, like in Dusseldorf, or the very back, like in Copenhagen, or whether I'm standing, I end up watching the telemonitor, and like, it's great to be there and feel the energy, but it's not about seeing, it's about feeling.
You know why you do that?
Why?
Because you're smarter. You always get those rehearsal tickets, which are also going on sale.
Yes, you can buy tickets for the jury final on the Friday evening and for the Saturday afternoon final on May 12th. And you know, people should not write these off. It's actually also fantastic because viewers at home all see the grand final, but they don't see the jury final because, you know, it's not telecast. And a lot of stuff happens at the jury final.
A lot of stuff happens.
Which is quite interesting. And they have the fake mock voting. It's quite fun as well if you can't get the tickets for the final. The jury final is a really good option.
Absolutely. And also, it accounts for half the scores. So in the jury final, you know, 50% of the vote is decided on what you end up seeing. So in some ways, it's actually really good because the grand final, you only see the other 50.
Yeah, it's a real kind of insider's game, I guess, that one. And also the Saturday afternoon show, that's the final rehearsal before the grand final.
This is when nothing can be changed. You really have to seal the deal at this point. And again, that's another great show to see.
Yeah, it's really, really exciting. Are you buying tickets, Devin?
Do you know what? I love Eurovision, and I have been seated in the arena for all shows. I love watching it on TV after the fact. But you've got to be in there. You can't travel all the way to Lisbon not to buy tickets. November 30th at 11 a.m. CET, I will be there. But you know what is really a smart move?
Tell me.
Those who are members of fan clubs, the OGAE clubs.
Yes.
This year, they have allocated 1,700 tickets for fans alone.
Packages, right?
Oh, 1,700 packages, you're right.
That's 1,700. Last year, it was only 900.
Oh. Last year actually started at zero.
And then after negotiation with OJE, it went up to 900. But this year it's 1,700. Huge jump. So those of you in the fan club, stay tuned, talk to your club. You'll get more info. Now, we've got to talk about the semifinals. These tickets, these are for the Tuesday evening show, the Thursday evening show, and then of course the accompanying rehearsals and jury finals. They go on sale in January.
Absolutely. You know, Lisbon is all about prioritizing fans, making sure they all get aboard, prioritizing those who want to see it, locals, those who are flying in. It's really important to start this early. I mean, Kiev was in, what, February?
Not till February, yeah. So people couldn't even book their flights because they didn't know if they had tickets. It was just a disaster.
And even then, technical hitches. I didn't get my ticket for Kiev until May.
Oh, OMG. Can I just say something else? If you don't get tickets to the grand final, you should still go to Eurovision. Let me tell you why. You can watch the semifinals, you can watch the jury show, and then the night of the grand final, you can watch it in a beautiful outdoor public space where they'll probably be broadcasting it, or you can watch it at a Portuguese bar, a Portuguese restaurant. There'll be venues all over the city airing the show, so you'll still be taking in the atmosphere, the excitement, seeing all the fans in their costumes, many of the acts at Eurovision Village during the week. You shouldn't think that that the only point of going to Eurovision is seeing the grand final. Obviously, that's a huge part of it, but there are other ways to enjoy it and digest it, which are much better than sitting at home in front of the telly.
And can I just suggest, you have much stronger chances of getting those tickets if you're in Lisbon than if you're in your home city, wondering whether you're going to get a ticket or not.
Yeah, I've got to say, I remember in Oslo, my first Eurovision.
I didn't have a ticket, but I got in anyway.
People, there were some ways to get them. Now look, so just to review, tickets go on sale Thursday, November 30th at what time?
11 a.m. CET.
So what is that, 10 GMT?
Absolutely.
10 London, 11 Paris, honey.
And also, it's just for the grand final, which make up the first wave of tickets, which will be released. They range from?
Wait a minute, it's grand final plus jury show the Friday night before.
And a Saturday afternoon.
Rehearsal, so that's May 11th, May 12th we're looking at here.
How much are you gonna spend on that day?
I gotta check my notes. So there are various levels from 35 euros to 299 euros.
Absolutely, and it will be on Blue Tickets, who's the official...
Can I just say, don't spend 300 euros on a ticket. You don't need to buy the 30 whatever...
William!
...ticket.
I always get the best tickets.
That is too much money. I'm sorry.
You know what? I'm committed to this contest. I'm passionate about it. And you spend money on your passions.
But you can feel the passion at a 35-year-old level, trust me, because the people around you will be just as excited. Because oftentimes people buying the really expensive tickets are corporates who don't even like the show, they're just there to experience it. Because they're like, oh, I'm a Lisbon executive at the company sponsoring it, so I'm gonna go to... Anyways, point of story is,
can I just say,
don't feel bad if you can't afford an expensive ticket.
Don't feel bad, but prioritize Eurovision. Eurovision is my priority, honey. Yes. I'm keeping it real.
You're saving those Vietnamese dong.
Oh, God!
Those Chinese renminbi. Yes! Ukrainian, what is it?
Romania!
Yes! OMG. I was gonna say Greek drachma, but they used the euro.
They pulled out.
In any case, that's what we're thinking about the tickets. Are you excited? Are you saving up your coins? Will you be there? And if you are there, will you say hey to us? Please do. Hey! Let us know here on Movie Blogs.
But in the meantime, you can follow us on our social media platforms, and we are on Instagram, Pinterest, Snapchat, YouTube, Facebook, Tumblr.
And San Marino 1 in 360 website.
Yes! Yes, Gaga, you look so good.
Is that for real?
Of course it's real! We know trolls. We'll see you later.
Bye!